Alright, my dear, so in this video, Daughter Valley, we are going to learn about elastic constants and, of course, relation among all. So this is Ujjwal Kumar Sen. Well, today I am going to share with you all these things, okay? So let's go for it. I hope you are interested to learn all things, right? So basically, what are elastic constant? Okay? So this is important. And of course, relation also important because if you are preparing for GATE examination or even university examination, so what actually what happened in university examination exam and GATE exam? GATE exam will not ask you any derivation, but university examination I have seen they ask you derivation from this relation among all. Probably they will give you some relation and they will tell you derive this equation, okay? So this is in that way you can get question. Other than this, you can get numerical problem also among the relation. Okay. Now let's talk about elastic constants. What are elastic constants? Okay. So basically these constants are relation between two things. One is stress and another is strain. But elastic constant differ from types of strain and types of strain because there are many types of strain. Many types of stress. So according to that, the elastic constant also keep on changing. I mean that their name is also keep on changing, right? So basically, what is elastic constant? So the relation between stress and strain. So not most of the time, all the time we'll see stress is on the top and strain is on the division side. Okay. So first of all, Young's modulus, or sometimes we know it is as modulus of elasticity. It is denoted by E. You will see almost 99.9% book that Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity is denoted by E, and it is equal to longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. Now maybe you wanted to know what is longitudinal stress and longitudinal strain. Basically, what is, I mean, if there is anything happen because of in this direction, in case of length, in linear direction you can say also, that is known as longitudinal stress. If stress is happening in that direction, that is known as longitudinal. If strain is happening in that direction, that is known as longitudinal strain. So most of the time what happen, longitudinal stress is equal to force by area and longitudinal strain is equal to delta L by L. Okay, this is simple, force by area, P for force, but this one is maybe little bit difficult for you. Suppose that, let me make you understand through diagram, that's why it will become quite easier for you to understand about it. Suppose that we are putting a load here from this direction and this direction, okay, PP. Because of this load, the shape of the body is changing to this and the length is also increasing L1. So delta L is what? L1 minus L. And this is known as what? Change in length. Change in length. And this L is known as this. This is known as what? In terms, in language you can say this is known as original length. Okay. So this is about modulus of elasticity and or Young modulus. Now how this Young's modulus come, I mean how we relate this one, that is also important, right? So basically we studied about it in Hooke's law, and believe me my dear, in Hooke's law I have shared with you a lot of things, and that was one of the most amazing I think video in all over the world you can see about Hooke's law. That's what amazing. View that video, watch that video, that is just amazing. If you wanted to learn about Hooke's law, then that is just awesome. Okay, that is different thing. So Hooke's law, what it state, sigma stress is directly proportional to strain and sigma but within the elastic limit. Yes, within the elastic limit. stress is directly proportional to strain, and this one is EE. So this E is also known as this one, Young's modulus, and here we got E is equal to stress by strain, and these two are longitudinal only. That's why I have written here longitudinal stress by longitudinal strain. Got it? Now let's go for the another elastic constant whose name is modulus of rigidity. Sometimes it is also denoted by N, modulus of G N, or somewhere it is also denoted by theta, but most of the time modulus of rigidity is denoted by G. So remembering these things is always helpful, sometimes also C, okay, is always helpful. Why I am sharing with you? Probably, you know, there are many books out there, they have also denote with different things to make them unique, or that is their matter, that is not my matter. But my matter is all about to help you to understand modulus of rigidity. So basically, what is modulus of rigidity? This thing is happening, you know, theta also, this is happening, that's because of shear stress by shear strain. And the formula of this is this only, shear stress by shear strain. Okay, again I am telling you, if you don't understand the concept of stress and strain, you must watch my video about stress and strain. That will help you to understand its basic concept, types, as well as many things what you need to know about stress and strain. So modulus of rigidity, what is this? Shear stress by shear strain. Again, I'm telling you, stress is nothing. Shear stress and shear strain is differ from longitudinal stress and longitudinal strain, because this is happening only because of there is something acting in the angle. Suppose that if you wanted to understand about shear strain, then let me share with you. Suppose this is a body and there is a force acting here, and because of this force, the body shape is changing from here to, suppose that this is B and this is B dash, right? And this is O, okay. So what would be shear strain? B1B by OB. This is known as shear strain, okay. So I hope you understand about shear strain, right? So now in case of stress, you know, if something is happening, I mean something is acting perpendicular, that is known as, you know, that is known as stress. But if it is acting tangentially, then it is known as tangentially, force is acting tangentially, then it is known as, you know, what is that? Shear stress. If it is acting, force is acting tangentially, that's why shear stress is also known as tangential stress. Remember that. That's why shear stress is also known as tangential stress. You need to remember this, okay. So this is all about modulus of rigidity, which is most of the time denoted by capital G. Now let's come to the bulk modulus. Bulk modulus. Well, I have seen 5 to 6 books. I have read 5 to 6 books. Okay. So before teaching as well, before making this video, so I have gone through all things what they're talking about, and I have also talked to my friends, my teachers about all topics, what should be the thing I should share with you in the videos. That's why it becomes quite helpful for you people, right? So what is happening? Bulk modulus is always represented by, almost all author represented by K only, and it is known as direct stress by volumetric strain. And volumetric strain is denoted by small ev or epsilon v. Okay, direct stress is simply sigma. So don't get confused with these two, because many books are denoting with different things. I don't want that. I wanted to share with you both, and I wanted to share with you all. That's why you'll have all things together in this video only. Don't need to go anywhere else. This is my main motto, okay. So this is all three elastic constants, and these constants, believe me my dear, one more thing that is also important, all these elastic constants having a single unit, that is Pascal or newton per meter square in SI. If you are talking about unit system, then all these, I am repeating again, I know this, all these elastic constant having the same unit, in SI, that is newton per meter square or pascal. Now let's go for another thing, that's numerical problem I would like to share with you. But before going to solve the numerical problem, I must share with you the relation among all elastic constant. Relation among all elastic constant. If you are studying about gate or any numerical problems from this subject in this topic, then this is very, very important. I must say that this is really important. So if you are preparing for gate, then that's just amazing for you to understand, to remember all these relations. So there are four relations I'm going to share with you, and all relations are elastic constant, as well as one thing is also I have involved, that is Poisson ratio. In my upcoming video, I'll share with you what is Poisson ratio with different way, and definitely you will get some basic concept of that also in that video only. But in this video, I'm going to share with you only four relations. Yeah, end of the video, you will get what is that? You get a numerical problem which has been asked in GATE 2000. I couldn't remember in which year they have asked, but not in earlier, it has as some years ago. So 3k minus 2g, 6k plus 2g. Now E equal to 3k 1 minus 2 mu. Another one is E equal to 9k g 3k plus g, and another one is E equal to 2g 1 plus mu. These are four relations among all elastic constant. Okay, so if you are preparing for GATE, I will suggest you just remember all these relations. Really, these relations will help you to solve numerical problems also. Okay, so I hope you understand all these relations. I'm not understanding, these all are just remembering. You need to remember, right? Now, the numerical problem I wanted to share with you, that is here only. This is the numerical problem. Basically, this is a simple concept. You just need to understand the question and you have to go through it, right? So what in this question states that in terms of Poisson ratio, that is mu, okay, the ratio of Young's modulus to shear modulus g of elastic constant. That means we have to relate three things, mu, E and g, to solve the problem, and we have to get the answer in terms of, as you can see, Poisson ratio. Now I have shared with you few formulas and few relations. As you can see, these are four relations. Now as you can see, there are three things only they have shared, E and G and mu. So can you see any relation which is just denoting these three things? Yes, this is the fourth number relation I have shared with you, E equal to 2G 1 plus mu. So just write that equation, E is equal to 2G 1 plus mu. Okay, now don't be in hurry, just go through it slowly. That's why you can mark the right answer. This is the right approach to solve the problem, and mark the right answer, because if you mark the wrong answer, you are not going to get any marks. Even you have to give marks to the examiner, because most of the time minus marking would be there. So what it state, that the ratio of Young's modulus to shear modulus, that means we have to find out E by G is equal to what? Simple, what you have to do, just transfer this G to this side. So E by G is equal to 2 1 plus mu. We have to check the right answer, which one is right answer we have given in this problem, that is C. So C is the right option for this question. So as you have seen right now, that how they can ask you question in this, from this all this relation, and of course I guess you understand the topic which I wanted to make you understand. Okay, thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. Bye bye.